Always a challenge to take the post-lunch session, but I'll try to make it as interesting for you so that you, since you spent so much of your time here, try to make it worth it. As introduced, I'm Deepak, and I look at customer-facing applications within Asian Paints. What that means is anything to do with customer experience. I get along with the business guys, try to understand how technology can actually help them build those delightful customer experiences for our present and potential customers. So what I've done is I've come here because we are customers of Aspect. So my case study would be centered around what we have done on customer experiences and how technology has helped. I gather that the audience here is largely business related, so I'll try to keep the technology stuff to the minimum and try to see if there's something which you can pick up from our experiences in managing our customers. So here we go. Just before we get into the presentation, this is Asian Paints. We are India's largest paint company. We've been market leaders for close to around 50 years now, and the dominance is pretty high in the decorative segment. If you see, the paint market is classified into decorative. That is where consumers like you would get into painting by visiting a dealer. Then you have the automotive segment, wherein we have a tie-up with Asian PPG. And then you have the industrial business, wherein it gets most into protecting your refineries, doing road markings, protective floor coatings, etc. We are close to $2 billion in revenue, and we are trying to, as a vision for ourselves, we've aspired to be among the top 5 decorative paint companies in the world. Currently, we are very close there. We are there, I guess, at number 4 because of the dollar fluctuations. It keeps moving a little up and down, but we are doing well there. So our vision there is to become among the top 5 decorative companies by leveraging our expertise in high growth emerging market. So if you see, we are there largely in the emerging markets. 17 countries is where we operate from. 23 countries, we've got 23 manufacturing facilities there. We operate as Skip Paints in Egypt. We have Berger in the Caribbean islands, Asian Paints in Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, and Nepal, and APCO in the Solomon Islands. So getting straight into what are the strategic imperatives of our vision. To be there in the top 5, I guess we need to build loyalty through top class customer experiences. This is something which every employee within the organization understands and is pretty passionate about. How does my work actually contribute to the customer? There's a customer centricity initiative which is driving this, but I'll not get into details of that. Managing governance, risk, and compliance, that's something where as you grow, we have seen tremendous growth in the last 10 years. That's going to be pretty critical, and increasing operational efficiency. So to do that, you'll have to be innovative, you'll have to be extremely customer-centric, you'll have to have the entire organization working like a unit because we are there across so many countries. So collaboration needs to be pretty bang on there. And then the entire expertise which we get by operating in the Indian subcontinent can be leveraged across. So if you look at our customers, the case study which I'm taking you through would be largely India-based, largely for customers in the decorative segment. Decorative, I said, anything which gets into your interiors, exteriors is decorative. It also covers people who are intending to paint their offices or cooperative housing societies. So if you look at our customer universe, you have the dealer there, the typical mom-and-pop retailer who would be placing his order on us. So we have got around 30,000 of them who would, on a regular basis, be placing order on us. We've got around 125 sales offices on which an order is placed, and the material goes to these dealers. US customers will be walking into the dealer shop to pick a paint of your choice. Then there's a contractor who in our segment is the applicator. He's the one who would help you apply the paint along with his battery of painters. In the Indian context, we as customers are very comfortable with the contractor. So I remember when my father wanted to paint his house, we went to our own contractor, who is a pretty trusted one. So he plays a very dominant role in the Indian subcontinent. So he's one of our big customers. This interior designer and architects, as we call it, is called AID. They are a huge segment which is emerging. We've seen over the last 7-8 years with disposable incomes being so high, people are willing to invest in designer services. And these are the designers whom we typically call as influencers. So they apart from suggesting what needs to go into a home decor, they also speak about color and what paint goes into it. So we, as an active customer segment, we do a lot of targeted programming for the interior designer and architects. For the end customers, that is customers like you and me who would want to buy paint from the dealer shop. We also have a services offering where we say we'll paint your entire house and give an end-to-end service. That's called Home Solutions. It's there in 13 cities, and it's a service which comes with a guarantee, and we have some unique offerings wherein we provided you a signature effect on your wall as well. So this is largely the customer set which we deal with. We have what you see here is programs which are targeted towards these. Like the Master Strokes here is a loyalty program which we run out of for our customers, for the contractors. So every time a contractor picks up a tin of Asian Paints, he gets certain points from it, and it gets accounted to his name. For the end customers, you have Home Solutions. We have a service called Foresight. You give us a photograph of your house, and we'll turn around three options of that to you, and then you can decide which one best suits you in terms of the color combinations, and then you can go to the dealer and pick up those colors. Or we're launching something called Color Consultancy at Home. So you have a consultant who will come to your home and give you advice on how you need to go about making your color choices. So all these customers would come through us through various channels. So those channels are largely, today we've seen predominantly the telephony channel, followed by the chat channel. On the website, we would have two types of chats wherein you can come for normal query-related chat. You would want to know about, I have a budget of so much and I would want to get my houses painted. What are the different type of paints you can offer? And there is color consulting chat, which is offered through the website, wherein they'll come in with specific questions saying that I am looking at giving a very sober touch to my house and what colors go with it. Now, both these chats are free as of today, and we see a lot of people. In fact, we have seen cases wherein people in the US would be chatting with a color consultant in India and get their houses in Bangalore painted. So that's the type of experience we have seen when we're managing these customers on chat. So with this, we said business is all about managing these interactions, because if you see there, you have got so many interactions, so many customers. I need to have a 360 degree view of any customer who comes, chats with me. So we said, let's set ourselves with certain principles of interaction. So we said Asian Paints' vision anyway is to be the most customer-centric company in the world, wherein we constantly anticipate our end users' existing and changing needs and see how best you can put in products and services which would cater to that. So for us, customer centricity would mean knowing your customer intimately, positioning products, as I said, and whatever interaction which I have with him at all points, may it be a contact center helpline agent who is talking to the customer, or may it be the chat agent, or may it be an in-person interaction, it has to be customized, it has to be personalized, it has to be consistent. So you need to have a lot of processes, you need to have a lot of people who will deliver that experience, and then there's technology which is going to model these processes. The other thing which we believe is the customers chooses the channel of interaction. We can't say that we are not there in this channel. In fact, we've gone to the social media, wherein we are looking at actively engaging with customers in social media. So that case, anyway, I would be covering at the end. So we see a certain customer segment which is very comfortable passing on their feedback through the social media. So these channels is something which we constantly scan for and see how customers are willing to interact with these channels. So what we said with all these interactions, I guess it makes sense to put in a next generation interaction model. So what we said, take a typical customer, you're a dealer, contractor, or customer. He might come in to place an order. He can come in for query resolution, or he might just seek some information. Now, I need to have an infrastructure which is able to take all these customers in terms of engaging with them. I need to have a multi-channel contact center. That's where, and that channel needs to offer chat, telephony, web services, social media integration. And then there is a customer interaction center which is having the right processes to deliver that consistent and unified experience. The other thing you said is it should not stop there, because this interaction center is something which is the front end of your organization. It has to connect to your back end system. So your back end system would be employees like me and you who would be actually servicing the customer directly or indirectly. Now somewhere we need to engineer that in a collaborative way. That's why I said the entire thing needs to be done in a very collaborative manner. Just to give you an experience, how is the experience getting transformed? Previously, before we put up this next generation interaction center, our dealers used to call us. We used to have around 120 sales offices. Each sales offices had its own EPBX. Each of them had a separate order taker. There was a separate order puncher that used to get into the SAP system, and then the material used to get delivered from the respective depots. Now, in this model, we typically saw that this was the type of experience. We have a dealer who calls, and then you have the Madhav, the order taker. he'll typically ask who's on the line because he has no clue to who's called. And then he says, my name is Sanjay, I would like to place an order. And then they'll ask, what is your customer code? Can you give me the order details? And then that mother would have written it on a notepad and transferred it to a order taker, your Tina in this case, who punches the order into the SAP system. And then material would have got dispatched. Somewhere the dealer would have felt, this is an okay experience, everybody is giving me. There's nothing personalized in it. And most of the times, when I call the branch, if I was lucky, I'll get to the right person, or sometimes I have to wait in the queue. So we said it was a one-star experience. Now there are 30,000 dealers who are calling us on a near daily basis. Now how can we actually take that experience to a level where he really feels delighted about it, and he continues to, that stickiness factor with us in terms of doing business, how do we improve that? So what we did is we went about saying, instead of having so many EPBXs across, instead of having so many order takers across, the skill of the order takers varying because some were very educated, some were very customer oriented, some were not. How do we standardize that experience? We said, let's put a centralized contact center. Instead of taking order taking locally, let's do it centrally. So we put a central contact center powered by Aspect, and we announced a toll-free number. We did away with a separate order taker and a separate order puncher. We said, let's get a more a better profile who can take orders and punch it into the system. System-wise also, we did a lot of changes in, wherein we gave a very user-friendly order entry screen. We tried to put a 360-degree view of the customer who is calling. So whenever a customer would call, it got integrated to the SAP system, and I knew exactly who had called, when did he place his last order, what are the type of complaints that particular dealer would have at any point of time. So with this as an experience, this is how it would look. Sanjay would call, and then the order taker would say, good morning Sanjay, it's your birthday, falana falana, and there would be some personalization which would happen there. Tell me your query, says, thanks Tina, I would want to check what is my performance in a particular scheme which is launched. She says, just hold on, you're in the premium league, sir, just a few points from getting into the diamond league based on his performance. And then he said, I need to understand the workings of the scheme. Then obviously the help desk, the contact center agent would not have that much visibility to that. So she says, just hold on, I'll put you onto a brand manager. And he checks whether the brand manager is there, Leila, the brand manager is there. And then they connect Leila, connecting the dealer to Leila, and then they talk, they understand what the scheme is like. And finally, at the end of the discussion, she says, I hope it's all clarified. And he says, I'm fine, thank you. And he feels at the end of this interaction, it was very personalized. He felt it was an efficient way of doing things. And the person who was actually talking to that customer knew exactly who that customer was and what sort of profile, and was able to service that particular request. Going ahead, we can do a lot of stuff wherein, with so much of data getting into a system, I can predict, I can get into predictive mode where I can tell you what is the type of order he's going to place. So I can just pre-populate the order taking screen with those line items saying that this is probably what you're going to place, and then just go and edit that. So we can do a lot of cross-sell, upsell also, which is the second phase which we're doing right now. So this is what we say is a five-star experience wherein the customer really feels good about it. So the contact center powers this dealer process. We have got 30,000 calling here. We have close to around 70% of our overall turnover running on this contact center. 11 languages supported. We have around close to 6 lakhs of monthly calls, wherein the average handling time would be in the range of 120 to 130 seconds. We monitor that very closely. There are a lot of matrices which we monitor, which are all right from the time an order is placed to the time it gets delivered to the dealer. We monitor all the SLAs therein. SLAs would be whether the agent has picked the phone on time, whether the order got punched in that average handling time. We are also putting in devices within the truck which carries the material to the dealer, which is managed by the GPS, whether the truck reached with, because we have committed to our customers in metro towns, that is the dealers, that we'll deliver material within 4 hours of them placing an order. So, yeah, I'll wind it up. So we try to model the entire order to delivery cycle, and that's where we feel a lot of dealers have expressed immense satisfaction in which it's getting managed. We also while what I spoke till now was largely for the dealers, we also manage our customers through the same infrastructure. We have got customers who call in for queries, who call in for general information. We've also got the entire complaint handling process managed through the contact center. We've got we do a lot of ad campaigns wherein customers are asked to respond to particular so the action, call to action type of campaigns which come in. We see that these are pretty seasonal now. Now the next 3-4 months would be a season for us. So you'll see a huge spike happening in the next 2-3 months. So we've got a very flexible model of scaling up our agents. We look at a lot of part-timers also. The infrastructure also needs to scale. So I'll come to the case. We're talking about how do you manage customer complaints, citation pains. So as a philosophy, we felt that we need to make our intent upfront there. We said we would want to be known as the most reliable brand in terms of customer support by building a competency where we can do an efficient customer recovery. So that competency needs to happen across the technology, process, and people. Building capabilities to close customer calls within 3 days of the call. So that is a SLA which we internally work with. We say either we compensate the customer or we have a satisfactory answer going to the customer that about any complaint which is put up. Integrating this entire customer handling process with the backend development system, so whatever feedback comes to us in the form of complaints can feed the product development team on a regular basis. So this is the philosophy behind which we said let's put up a process which will not only just build, not only help us, but also build that customer satisfaction and hence a loyalty. Because anyway, there is a lot of research which have said that when you attend a customer complaint well, he comes back to you again because his loyalty is won in that process. So as a process, we said we need to do it in 4 steps: reach, register, resolve, and re-engineer. In the reach part, we said you need to publish your intent pretty clearly. What do you want to do? So we said that we'll resolve all complaints within 3 days. Sensitize the value chain. It just can't be the contact center which is going to take this onus. It's going to be the entire value chain which is going to chip in. So we had to put in these processes there. We said that there needs to be a certain amount of service orientation at the point of contact. So some amount of processes got put in there. So I think I'm getting a little. I'll go. So this probably everybody would know it. The focus was largely on people, processes, and technology. We got into the details of the process. So we put in a complete exhaustive workflow which will manage the process. We got all the key personnel involved, made them responsible for their tasks. So we typically the people behind the process would be the contact center representative. Then there is a sales guy. Every time you call, a sales guy will come take an appointment and try to get a technologist there. The technologist will come and do a survey. He puts in a lot of details related to the nature of the complaint. The system will throw back whether this complaint is a new complaint or already existing complaint, and accordingly a decision is taken to compensate the customer, or we say it's probably a problem with the wall. Then the same complaint goes to the manufacturing single point of contact who looks at the batch sample. Then it goes to the technologist single point of contact who's supposed to internally check whether the formulations are right. And then if all of them have said it's fine, then we send it back to the marketing single point of contact who internally checks with the specs which were initially laid for that particular product were rightly defined. So there's a process, there's a huge process. It's a pretty complicated process which goes about at the back end to ensure that such complaints don't get repeated or the ones if they've occurred, corrective action is being taken. So the technology which powers this would be SAP CRM. We are customers of SAP end-to-end, and we've modeled the entire process on CRM. We use a service model which gives you the facility of offering a ticket. There's a workflow which you can build in SAP CRM. And then the entire contact center piece is handled by Aspect, wherein telephony, fax, chat is something which we are looking at integrating now. So a typical complaint process would be, what we are trying to do is, we are trying to see if the contact center can drive the SLA. So while in the system it would be defined that after 3 hours people need to call, we are trying to see whether the contact center can push for those SLAs wherein auto reminders, auto calls happening in terms of the SLA which is defined. The second part of it, we are trying to see if as the customer calls, his voice packet, can it get tagged in the CRM system? So whoever is attending to that complaint can hear before he goes to attend that particular complaint. So that is what we're trying to achieve. This is general scorecards. We're pretty good at closing because of the system processes there. I'll do fast. So the social media. We see a lot of complaints coming in through the social media. So what do we do there? We are upfront there in terms of Facebook, Twitter. So anybody who even on Facebook says that I wish to paint, or I went in for pink color and I got a darker shade of pink, we're able to grab that instance from the social media. And when we do that, we have a software called Explicate. It scans around close to whatever sites are there in terms of user forums, in terms of wherein people have gone and put in something related to paints. It filters and tells me that these are complaints, these are leads. So for the complaints, what we do for the person who has actually complained on the social media, we pick his contact details, that is email ID or mobile number, check it back with a CRM system. Does he exist as a customer? If he doesn't exist, we create a customer ID for him. A call happens to him, him or her, and then we engage the customer complaint process picks in. So whatever is the status gets fed back into the social media. So the updates keep, while the process takes over physically, the updates are pushed in the social media till the complaint gets resolved. So the components which would have typically used would be in a component from SAP called NetWare Gateway, and Aspect would be the telephony channel there, and SAP CRM here. So path ahead here, we're integrating the social media channel with the Aspect infrastructure. So anybody who tweets, immediately there is an alert which can go to the contact center, or you can do a possibly basis the D&D and all, we can call back that customer on an immediate basis, or even if a customer who is trying to put in a customer complaint, will chat will come up there and ask him, do you want somebody to call you? So we're trying to integrate that in the contact center. Yeah, I'll finish it off. Mobile. We also are enabling our sales guys who are attending complaints with tablets, so that they, if there's a possibility of closing the complaint then and there itself on the basis of certain rules, we can do that, so that 3 days can get reduced to probably a day or so. Voice of the customer to the employees as a part of this customer centricity initiative. All employees are supposed to listen to the complaints. At least an employee needs to visit a customer every year, two customers every year. So what we're trying to do is, can we get the recordings of the contact center onto the desktops or the laptops of the employees, so they also start getting into what sort of complaints our product should have, and is there something which they can do about it. There we're trying to see how technology can enable such voice packets going over a wide area network, because there are bandwidth restrictions. So that is something which we're working on. And then there are voice analytics based on what words are spoken in the call, or based on the tonality, is there some process which can get immediately kicked in and the same package travel to the right people, and how can we further crash that 3 days to probably a few hours. So that is something which we are working towards. So I just had a quick video which I picked up from YouTube. I guess if you offer that level of services, I think you'll have customers for life. Thanks, yeah.
Thank you.